السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. I welcome our dear brothers and sisters in Al-Islam. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum to our ikhwan and our akhawat. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, another majlis bi'ithnillahi ta'ala of us learning and studying the Arabic language. Walhamdulillah. Limadha? Why do you want to study the Arabic language? Limadha? Li'annaha lughat al-Qur'an. Because it is the language of the noble Qur'an. Li'annaha lughat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because it's the language of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, it is the language of al-Islam. Walhamdulillah. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah, we are currently in our Medina Arabic series. We are in volume number 3, MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. And in this majlis, we will begin with lesson number 12, walhamdulillah. In lesson number 11, we dealt with jumla ismiya, nominal sentences, and we know that they are broken up into the mubtada and the khabar, the subject and the predicate. We spoke about different types of mubtada, different types of khabar, walhamdulillah. We now move on bi'idhnillahi ta'ala to lesson number 12, ad-darsu thani ashar. What will we be covering in lesson number 12? We will discuss the ظرف زمان and the ظرف مكان. What's a ظرف زمان and ظرف مكان? Simply put in English, we call these adverbs. Adverbs. What's an adverb? Something which is giving us the time of the action or the place of the action. Giving us a description related to the time of the action or the place of the action. Example, kharajtu laylan. I exited at night. When did I leave? I left at night. So laylan is our ظرف زمان. This laylan at night is telling us the time of this action. سأسافر غدا. I will travel tomorrow. My traveling is going to happen when? Within what time frame? Tomorrow, mashaAllah. Nimtu tahta shajarati. I slept under the tree. This is a ظرف مكان. It's telling us about the place where the action took place. Nimtu, I slept. Tahta shajarati, under the tree. MashaAllah. Jalastu عند المديري. I sat with the principal. So عند المديري, this is our ظرف مكان. It's telling us about the place where you sat. You sat with the principal, mashaAllah. The rule is that these ظرف مكان and ظرف زمان, they are always منصوب. They are always منصوب, mashaAllah. Example, تحت, عند, بعد, قبل, etc. جميل, mashaAllah. Although there are some of the ظرف مكان and زمانs which are مبني. مبني meaning that they don't accept any change. And so we say with regards to them that they are في محل نصب. They are in the state of being منصوب. Example, حيث, wherever. قط, هنا, over here. متى, when. أمسي, yesterday. Aina, where. These are all ظرف مكان or ظرف زمانs, but they are مبني, they're not open to any changing, but they still منصوب. How? في محل نصب. In the form, in the state of being منصوب, mashaAllah. Also take note that we say ظرف زمان and ظرف مكان generally when it comes to a nominal sentence. But if we find the similar in a verbal sentence, we call it a مفعول فيه. مفعول فيه. جيد. Example. ضرب الوالد ولده أمام المسجد بعد العصر. ضرب الوالد. The father hit. ضرب verb, verbal sentence. ضرب الوالد, who did the hitting? The father. He is the fa'il, the doer. The father hit who? ولده, his son. The father hit his son. أمام المسجد, in front of the masjid. This is giving us the place where the action occurred. So you can call this a ظرف مكان, or because it's a verbal sentence, we will call this the مفعول فيه. مفعول فيه, the place in which this action took place, or the time frame in which this action took place. بعد العصر, after Salatul Asr. So this is also the maf'ul fihi, giving us the time. I repeat, ضرب الوالد ولده, the father hit his son. أمام المسجد is our مكان, is the place. It's our maf'ul fihi, telling us the place where this action of hitting took place. بعد العصر, after Salatul Asr, after Asr. And this is our maf'ul fihi, giving us the time in which the action took place. Walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. We will also learn in this exercise that there are some words that they function similar to a zarf. By default, they are not zarf makan or zarf zaman. They are not adverbs, but they are like naib zarf. They are like secondary type of zarfs. They take the place of the zarf and they do the function of the zarf, insha'Allah. We will see, for example, kulla, ba'da, some, ruba'a, sa'atin, a quarter of an hour, nisfa, when the mudafun ilay is denoting time or place. These words, they are usually mudaf. If the mudafun ilay is indicating time or place, then they function like a ظرف. We will also see, example, the sentence, جلست طويلا, I sat for a long period of time. Technically, there's a word missing here. جلست وقتا طويلا, وقتا طويلا. And so this طويلا is like a نائب ظرف. جئت هذا الأسبوع, جئت هذا الأسبوع, أسبوع in that sentence. مكثت في بغداد أربعة أيام. مكثت في بغداد, I remained in Baghdad for 4 days. أربعة أيام. And we will discuss that in further detail بإذن الله تعالى. We will also learn in this lesson, lesson number 12, we'll learn about the word low. Low. جيد. لو سمعت قصته لبكيت. If only you listened to his story, you would have cried. Low. If. جيد. لو عرفت أنك مريض. If only I knew that you were sick. ما تأخرت. I would not have delayed. So there's a condition and there's a consequence. لو سمعت قصته. If you heard his story, condition, then what would happen? What's the consequence? لبكيت. You would cry. You would have cried. جيد. لو اجتهد لنجحت. If only but you exerted yourself and you studied hard, then you would have passed. But you didn't study hard, and so you didn't pass. There's a condition and there's a consequence. Condition wasn't met, then obviously the consequence will not be met. And with regards to the matter of low, if it's in the affirmative, if the sentence is to do with the affirmative, then we bring a lam in our consequence. لو اجتهد لنجحت 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 لو اجتهد لنجحت. If you had studied, then you would have passed. لو سمعت قصته, if you heard his story, لبكيت لبكيت لبكيت. We bring the lam in our jawab. We bring the lam in our consequence. Whereas if it is something to do with the negative, then we do not bring a lam. لو عرفت أنك مريض, if I knew that you were sick, ما تأخرت, I would not have delayed. We do not bring any lam here. And we will go through many examples بإذن الله تعالى. Last matter that we will cover in this lesson is the matter of قبلو and بعدو. قبلو and بعدو, they become, or rather قبلا and بعدا, they become مبني if the مضاف إليه is omitted. من قبل ذلك, من بعد ذلك. So if we left out the ذلك, if we omitted the ذلك, remember in the sentence, the ذلك here is our مضاف إليه. من قبل ذلك, قبل ذلك, مضاف مضاف إليه. من بعد ذلك, من بعد ذلك. If we left out the مضاف إليه, then the قبل and the بعد, they become مبني and they take a ضمة. من قبل, من بعد, من قبل and من بعد. This is when we omit the مضاف إليه. والحمد لله. يا عبد الله, يا أمة الله. Simple lesson بإذن الله تعالى. And Allah makes it easy for whomsoever He wants to make it easy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us. رَبِّ يَسِّرْ وَلَا تُعَسِّرْ وَتَمِّمْ بِالْخَيْرِ. Oh our Rabb, yassir, make it easy. وَلَا تُعَسِّرْ, don't make it difficult. وَتَمِّمْ بِالْخَيْرِ, and let it be completed with goodness. والحمد لله. الدرس الثاني عشر المدرس. أرحب بكم, I welcome you people. في اليوم الأول, on the first day, من العام الجديد. The first day of the new year. أُرَحِبُ بِكُمْ فِي الْيَوْمِ الْأَوَّلِ مِنَ الْعَامِ الْجَدِيدِ. I welcome you people on the first day of the new year. ما شاء الله. مَتَى وَصَلْتُمْ, مَتَى وَصَلْتُمْ مِنْ بِلَادِكُمْ. When did you people arrive from your countries? مَتَى, when. وَصَلْتُمْ, وَصَلَ to arrive. وَصَلْتُمْ, you people arrived. From where? مِنْ بِلَادِكُمْ, from you people's countries. Ahmed says, وَصَلْنَا قَبْلَ أُسْبُوعٍ, وَصَلْنَا قَبْلَ أُسْبُوعٍ, we arrived a week ago, before 1 week. أَمَّا أَنَا فَوَصَلْتُ أَمْسِي. Al-Hussein says, أَمَّا أَنَا فَوَصَلْتُ أَمْسِي. As for me, I arrived yesterday. أَمَّا أَنَا فَوَصَلْتُ أَمْسِي. Ali says, أَنَا وَصَلْتُ يَوْمَ الثُّلَثَاءِ. أَنَا وَصَلْتُ يَوْمَ الثُّلَثَاءِ. I arrived يَوْمَ الثُّلَثَاءِ. By the way, if you look at these sentences here, almost every sentence has a ظرف مكان or a ظرف زمان. أرحب بكم في اليوم الأول من العام الجديد. متى, متى is a, متى is a ظرف. متى وصلتم, talking about time. متى وصلتم من بلادكم. وصلنا قبل أسبوع, قبل أسبوع. This is a ظرف زمان, before a week. أما أنا فوصلت أمسي. أمسي is a ظرف زمان. أنا وصلت يوم الثلاثاء. يوم الثلاثاء, I arrived when, ظرف زمان, يوم الثلاثاء. وذهبت إلى مكة لأداء العمرة. And I went to Mecca to perform عمرة. لأداء العمرة, to perform عمرة. وبقيت, وبقيت هناك ثلاثة أيام. And I remained there for 3 days. ورجعت البارحة. And I returned yesterday, last night. ورجعت البارحة. البارحة, the evening that just passed. أهلا وسهلا, the teacher says. جمال, يا أستاذ, أتسمح لي أن أجلس أمامك. Do you permit me to sit in front of you? أتسمح لي, do you permit me, أن أجلس أمامك, to sit in front of you? إن هذا المقعد, indeed this seat, خال. إن هذا المقعد خال. This seat is empty. فإن صاحبه, for indeed its companion, I mean, technically here doesn't mean companion, its owner, its sahib, its owner, the seat's owner, the person who's supposed to be sitting on the seat, طُوِيَ قَيْدُهُ الْعَامَ الْمَاضِي. طُوِيَ, ended. قيده his enrollment, his registration. العام الماضي فإن صاحبه طوي قيده العام الماضي فإن صاحبه طوي قيده العام الماضي. For indeed, the one who was seated here, his registration or his enrollment has come to an end last year. اجلس حيث شئت. Sit wherever you want. The teacher says, اجلس حيث شئت. Sit wherever you want. لا أريد أن أجلس تحت المروحة. I do not want to sit under the fan. فإن ذلك يضرني. For indeed that harms me. أفأجلس خلف جمال. Can I sit behind جمال؟ لا مانع لدي. I don't have any problem with that. لا مانع. I don't have any issue. لدي. No problem I have with that. أين سافرت في عطلة الصيف؟ Where did you travel in the summer holidays? هذه السنة يا أستاذ. Where did you travel in the summer holidays this year, O أستاذ? إلى إندونيسيا. To Indonesia. ألم تمر بكوالالمبورا؟ ألم تمر؟ Did you not pass by بكوالالمبور؟ Did you not pass by Kuala Lumpur? بلا, indeed, surely, definitely. لكنني لم أمكث فيها طويلا. But I didn't remain there for a long period of time. بلا, ولكنني لم أمكث فيها طويلا. But I didn't remain there for a long period of time. كم لبثت ثم يا أستاذ. How long did you remain there? كم لبثت ثم يا أستاذ. How long did you remain there? لبثت ثمة يوما أو بعض يوم. I was there for about a day or a portion of a day. لبثت ثمة يوما أو بعض يوم. لبثت ثمة يوما أو بعض يوم. I was there for about a day or a portion of a day. لو عرفت أنك تأتي إلى بلدي. Jamal says, if I knew that you were coming to my country, لاستقبلتك. I would have welcomed you في المطار. I would have been there to welcome you at the airport. أسافرت إلى سنغافورة أيضا. أسافرت إلى سنغافورة أيضا. Did you travel to Singapore also? Again. لو عرفت أنك تأتي إلى بلدي. If I knew that you were coming to my country, لاستقبلتك. I would have welcomed you في المطار at the airport. أسافرت. Did you travel إلى سنغافورة. Did you travel to Singapore also? لا. ألم تسافر إليها من قبل. Did you not travel to it previously? ألم تسافر إليها. Did you not travel to it من قبل, before? نعم, لم أسافر إليها قط. Yes, I've never traveled to it. لم أسافر إليها قط. Remember, a negative type of question. So, if the answer is negative, then we answer نعم. And if you're answering in the positive, then you would use بلا. So he says, نعم, لم أسافر إليها قط. I've never traveled to it. والحمد لله, ما شاء الله. So this was the passage between the teacher and his students, mashallah, tabarakallah. Quite a few ظرف مكان and ظرف زمانز in the passage, mashallah. Let's move on to the تمارين بإذن الله تعالى. Question number one. متى وصل الحسين؟ متى وصل الحسين؟ وصل الحسين أمس. وصل الحسين أمس. حسين arrived yesterday. كم يوما بقي علي في مكة؟ How many days was Ali in Mecca? بقي علي في مكة ثلاثة أيام. بقي علي في مكة ثلاثة أيام. بقي علي في مكة ثلاثة أيام. Excellent. Ali was in Mecca for 3 days. جميل. Number 3. لما لا يريد الزبير أن يجلس تحت المروحة؟ Why doesn't Zubair want to sit under the fan? لأن ذلك يضره. لأن ذلك يضره. Because that harms him. لأن ذلك يضره. لأن ذلك يضره. Because that harms him. Excellent. Number four. أين سافر المدرس في عطلة الصيف؟ سافر المدرس في عطلة الصيف إلى... Where did he go? إلى إندونيسيا. إلى إندونيسيا. سافر المدرس في عطلة الصيف إلى إندونيسيا. Number five. كم لبث في كوالالمبور? How long did he remain in Kuala Lumpur? لبث ثمة يوما أو بعض يوم. He was there for about a day or a portion of a day. لبث ثمة يوما أو بعض يوم. Excellent. والحمد لله. يا عبد الله يا أمة الله. Then they talk to us about the مفعول فيه. مفعول فيه. What's a مفعول فيه? Basically your ظرف زمان or your ظرف مكان but in a verbal sentence. Example. وصلت يوم الثلاثاء. هنا يوم is the مفعول فيه. المفعول فيه اسم منصوب. It is منصوب. يذكر لبيان زمان الفعل أو مكانه. It is mentioned to describe, to give us info about the place of the action or the time of the action. ويسمى أيضا ظرفا. And it's also called a ظرف. Example. خرجت ليلا. I went out at night. سأسافر غدا إن شاء الله. I will travel tomorrow إن شاء الله. نمت بعد نومك. I slept after your sleeping. So you can call it the مفعول فيه or you can call it ظرف زمان. Other examples. مشيت ميلا. I walked a kilometer. I walked a kilometer. So kilometer here, this is our ظرف مكان or مفعول فيه. جلست عند المدير. I sat with the principal. نمت تحت الشجرة. نمت تحت شجرة. I slept under a tree. نمت تحت شجرة. I slept under a tree. You can call this ظرف مكان or you can call it مفعول فيه. والحمد لله. بعض الظروف مبنية منها مبنية منها. These ظرف that they list for us now, they say to us that they are مبني. They're not open to any type of changing, but they are all في محل نصب. They are in the state of being منصوب. Remember we said that the ظرف مكان and ظرف زمان, they are all منصوب. Well, what if it cannot take a clear and apparent fatha, etc., then they will be in the state of being mansoob. متى تقول متى خرجت? When did you leave? هنا متى ظرف زمان مبني على السكون في محل نصب. It is مبني, it's not open to any changing, and it's in the state of being mansoob. أين أين تدرس? Where are you studying? Here أين is a ظرف مكان مبني على الفتح في محل نصب. It is مبني with a fatha and in the state of being منصوب. أمسي تقول لم أغب أمسي. I didn't stay absent yesterday. أمسي ظرف زمان مبني على الكسر في محل نصب. قط never. I have never done such and such. تقول لم أذق هذه الفاكهة قط. I have never tasted this fruit ever. هنا قط ظرف زمان. It's a ظرف زمان مبني على الضم في محل نصب. هنا here. اجلس هنا. Sit over here. This is a ظرف مكان and it's also في محل نصب. Excellent. الآن تقول الآن جئت. You've come now. ظرف زمان مبني على الفتح في محل نصب. حيث wherever. اجلس حيث شئت. Sit wherever you want. حيث is a ظرف مكان مبني على الضم في محل نصب. والحمد لله. هناك أسماء تنوب عن الظرف. And these are some words that function like the ظرف إن شاء الله. مضاف إلى الظرف مما دل على كلية الزمان أو المكان أو جزئيتهما. Example: سافرنا كل النهار. سافرنا كل النهار. We traveled the entire day. So كل النهار. سافرنا كل النهار. جيد. So كل this because the mudafun ilay is dealing with time, then technically this kulla functions like a zarf. Safarna kulla nahari. Intazartuka rub'a sa'atin. I waited for you 15 minutes, a quarter of an hour. Because after rub'a, we have a mudafun ilay which is dealing with time. So then technically rub'a functions like a zarf. Intazartuka rub'a sa'atin. مشيت نصف كيلومتر. نف مشيت نصف كيلومتر. I walked half a kilometer. Half a kilometer. So kilometer, that's the place that you had walked to. You had walked a kilometer. And so نصف will function like a ظرف here. هنا الكلمات كل وربع ونصف نابت عن الظروف. They are functioning like the ظرف. Number two, صفته. Example, جلست طويلا. I sat for a long period of time. أي وقتا طويلا. وقتا طويلا. هنا طويلا صفة للظرف نابت عنه. So طويلا is the adjective of وقتا. It's the describing word for وقتا. جلست وقتا طويلا. جلست وقتا طويلا. So طويلا is describing the time. And then we removed the وقتا. And so it just remained as جلست طويلا. جلست طويلا. اسم إشارة. Demonstrative pronoun. جئت هذا الأسبوع. I came this week. هنا this هذا نابع عن الظرف. It's also like taking the place and the function of a ظرف. جئت هذا الأسبوع. العدد, numbers. مكثت في بغداد أربعة أيام. I remained in Baghdad for 4 days. سرنا مئة كيلومتر. سرنا مئة. مئة كيلومتر. Here, أربعة and مئة عددان نابا عن الظرف. They are two words which are functioning like the ظرف والحمدلله. Exercises. Number one. استخرج ما في الدرس من الظروف الزمان والمكان. So go through the passage and pull out all of the ظرف مكان and all of the ظرف زمان. That's a big exercise. Try it. So you read through the entire passage and pull out the ظرف مكان and ظرف زمان. Let's see. متى وصلتم من بلادكم. The word متى. متى is a ظرف زمان. وصلنا قبل أسبوع. قبل. قبل is a ظرف زمان. ظرف زمان. أما أنا فوصلت أمسي. 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 أمسي is a ظرف زمان. أتسمح لي أن أجلس أمامك. أمام. 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 In front. In front. So ظرف مكان. اجلس حيث شئت. Wherever, حيث, حيث, wherever, ظرف مكان. لا أريد أن أجلس تحت المروحة تحت ظرف مكان. أفأجلس خلف جمال. خلف, خلف, ظرف مكان. Adverb of place. أين سافرت في عطلة الصيف؟ Where did you travel in the summer holiday? أين, أين, أين is a ظرف مكان. We are asking about place here. ألم تسافر إليها من قبل. قبل. قبل is a ظرف زمان. لم أسافر إليها قط. قط is a ظرف زمان. لبثت ثمة يوما أو بعض يوم. بعض يوم. جيد. بعض يوم. بعض is a ظرف زمان. Also يوما is a ظرف زمان. ثمة is a ظرف مكان. ثمة, that place there, is a ظرف مكان. لبثت ثمة يوما. I remained at that place there for a day. أو بعض يوم, or a portion of a day. Walhamdulillah. That covers, insha'Allah, the ظرف مكان and زمانs from the passage. Number two, استخرج ما فيه من الظروف المبنية. So they want you to pull out all of the ظرف that are مبني. That are مبني. Simple. متى, أمسي, أين, متى, when. أمسي, yesterday, أين, where, قط, ever or never. حيثو, wherever. So those are the ظروف مبنية. استخرج منه كلمات نابت عن الظرف. So those words that are functioning like a ظرف. We saw, for example, بقيت هناك ثلاثة أيام. بقيت هناك ثلاثة. ثلاثة, that number. ثلاثة أيام. ثلاثة أيام. أين سافرت هذه السنة؟ أين سافرت هذه السنة؟ أين سافرت هذه السنة؟ So هذه, هذه, this اسم إشارة, هذه acting like a ظرف. لبثت بعض يوم. لبثت بعض, بعض يوم, بعض يوم. لم أمكث فيها طويلا. I didn't remain there for long. لم أمكث فيها طويلا. طويلا, طويلا, acting like a ظرف. Excellent, ما شاء الله. Number four, عين ظروف الزمان والمكان فيما يأتي. They give us 10 sentences and they want you to pull out the ظرف زمان or the ظرف مكان. Let's see. انتظر لحظة. Wait a moment. انتظر لحظة. You say to the brother, انتظر لحظة. Wait a moment. Wait a moment. So what is our ظرف here? لحظة. لحظة. لحظة is our ظرف زمان. لحظة, a moment, time. Wait a moment. Next one. جلس أراد قف حيث أمرتك. قف حيث أمرتك. قف حيث أمرتك. Stand where I order you. جيد. Stand where I order you. قف حيث أمرتك. What is our ظرف here? حيث. حيث is our ظرف مكان. Stand where I order you. Wherever I order you. حيث, wherever. So that's a ظرف مكان. Then we have جلس الزوار. الزوار عند المدير نصف ساعة. جلس الزوار, the guests, the visitors, they sat with the principal for half an hour. What's our ظرف here? عند. Also نصف ساعة. عند is a ظرف مكان, place. نصف ساعة is our ظرف زمان. كم ساعة بقي الجريح في المستشفى؟ How many hours did the injured one remain in the hospital? كم ساعة بقي الجريح؟ How long did the injured one, the one who has the جرح, the جريح, the person who is injured في المستشفى? What's our ظرف here? كم. كم. ظرف زمان, dealing with time. كم. How many hours? Try it. Number five. أتسافر إلى الرياض هذا الشهر؟ أتسافر إلى الرياض هذا الشهر؟ هذا. أتسافر إلى الرياض هذا الشهر؟ هذا الشهر. This month. ظرف زمان. أقبل الأذان ذهبت إلى المسجد أم بعده؟ أقبل الأذان ذهبت إلى المسجد أم بعده؟ Before the أذان you went to the masjid or after it. What's our ظرف here? قبل and also بعد. ظرف زمانس. قبل and بعد. They are ظرف زمانس. صبرت طويلا. أراد صبرت. I had صبر. صبرت طويلا. I observed صبر for a long period of time. صبرت طويلا. I observed صبر for a long period of time. What's our ظرف? طويلا. طويلا. ظرف زمان. ظرف زمان of time. نمت كل الليل. نمت كل الليل. I slept the entire night. كل. ظرف مكان. كل الليل. نمت كل الليل. I slept the entire night. This would be a ظرف زمان. ظرف زمان. The entire night. Night is time. Night is time, not a place. الساعتين نمت أم ثلاث ساعات؟ أساعتين نمت أم ثلاث ساعات؟ You slept for 2 hours or 3 hours. جيد. ساعتين أساعتين 2 hours. That's our ظرف زمان. And also ثلاثة of ثلاث ساعات. That's also another ظرف زمان. أين مكثت هذه المدة؟ أين مكثت هذه المدة؟ Where were you all of this time? أين is a ظرف مكان and هذه المدة is a ظرف زمان. ظرف زمان it's an adverb of time. والحمد لله. عين ظروف الزمان والمكان في الآيات الكريمة الآتية. ما شاء الله. So they give us these verses and they want us to pull out the ظرف مكان or the ظرف زمان.
وجاءوا أباهم عشاء يبكون.
الله مستعان. When the brothers of Yusuf عليه السلام they came وجاءوا and they came أباهم to their father عشاء يبكون. They came at the time of the evening and they were in tears. They were crying. الله مستعان. Tears in reality, tears of crocodile tears. Those were fake tears. Tears shed by the crocodiles. Allah musta'an. وَجَاءُوا أَبَاهُمْ عِشَاءً يَبْكُونَ. They come to their father and they are in tears that, you know, what has happened to our brother Yusuf alayhi salam. Allah musta'an. Ya Abdullah, ya Amat Allah, what's our ظرف here? عِشَاءً. That's our ظرف زمان. They came to their father in the evening.
وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا
And we built upon them, over them. وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ And built over them سَبْعًا شِدَادًا So here, فَوْقَكُمْ فَوْقَكُمْ is our ظرف مكان. Above them, فَوْقَكُمْ
قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِي لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا
The Nabi, he says, إني دعوت قومي, I called my people, I made da'wah to my people, ليلًا during the night, ونهارًا and during the day, night and day, I did da'wah to them, الله مستعان. ليلًا ونهارًا, these are ظرف زمانs, during the night time and during the daytime.
وما تدري نفس ماذا تكسب غدا.
And no soul knows, no person knows what they will earn tomorrow.
وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدَى
غَدَى, tomorrow, ظرف زمان, tomorrow, the time.
وَقِيلَ الْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاكُمْ كَمَا نَسِيتُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا
And it will be said to them, today, نَنْسَاكُمْ, we will forget you people,
كَمَا نَسِيتُمْ, as you forgot us.
As you forgot لقاء يومكم, as you forgot this meeting here, Allah musta'an. ظرف زمان, ظرف زمان لقاء يومكم. No. وقيل اليوم, اليوم, اليوم is a ظرف زمان. اليوم is a ظرف زمان.
وقيل اليوم ننساكم. Today you people will be forgotten. كما نسيتم, like you forgot our meeting, this meeting here.
الله مستعان, الله مستعان. يا عبد الله, يا أمت الله, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 6, they ask us, هات ثلاث جمل تحوي كل واحدة منها عددا نابع عن الظرف. They want us to bring 3 sentences where we have something some word functioning like a ظرف, functioning like a ظرف. Example, انتظرت I waited 10 دقائق. I waited 10 minutes. انتظرت 10 دقائق. انتظرت 10 دقائق. انتظرت 10 دقائق. Another one.
بقيت في المدينة 30 عاما.
I remained in the city for 30 years.
بقيت في المدينة 30 عاما. بقيت في المدينة 30 عاما. 30 عاما. 30 عاما. 30 عاما.
That's our ظرف.
مشينا ثلاثة كيلومترات. مشينا ثلاثة كيلومترات. مشيت أراد مشينا. We walked. مشينا ثلاثة كيلومترات. We walked 3 kilometers. 3 kilometers. So in the three sentences, we had numbers. And all those numbers functioned like ظرفs. عشرة ثلاثين ثلاثة. Excellent. Exercise number 7. Provide 3 sentences. And in each one of them, there's an ism ishara that is operating and functioning like a ظرف. رجعت من السفر هذا الأسبوع. رجعت من السفر هذا الأسبوع. رجعت من السفر هذا الأسبوع. I returned from travel this week. أدرس اللغة الفرنسية هذه السنة. أدرس اللغة الفرنسية هذه السنة. هذه السنة. هذه السنة. أدرس اللغة الفرنسية هذه السنة. أين كنت ذاك اليوم؟ أين كنت ذاك اليوم؟ أين كنت ذاك اليوم؟ Where were you on that day? جيد. Excellent. ما شاء الله. أدخل كل ظرف مما يأتي في جملة مفيدة. They give us these words and they want us to make sentences which make sense, inshallah, with these ظرفs. Excellent. Let's see. قبل. ذهبت إلى المسجد قبل الأذان. ذهبت إلى المسجد قبل الأذان. بعد. ذهبت إلى المكتبة بعد العصر. I went to the library after عصر. ذهبت إلى الدكان بعد العصر. Excellent. عند سليمان عند المدير. سليمان is عند المدير, is with the principal. رأيته أمام المسجد. I saw him in front of the masjid. رأيته أمام المسجد. خلف, behind. رأيتها خلف البيت. I saw her behind the house. نمت تحت شجرة. I slept under a tree. تحت شجرة or تحت الشجرة, under the tree. فوق, sentence with فوق. فوق, جيد. فوق الكتاب. فوق الكتاب. فوق المكتب. The book is on top of the desk. فوق المكتب. جيد. هنا. Here. اجلس هنا. اجلس هنا. اجلس هنا أمامي. Sit here in front of me. ثم سافرت إلى مكة وبقيت ثم أياما. سافرت إلى مكة وبقيت ثم أياما. أو ثمة أيام. وبقيت ثم أياما. جيد. ورد في الدرس. لو عرفت أنك تأتي إلى بلدي. If I knew that you were coming to my country. لاستقبلتك. I would have welcomed you في المطار. They say that this لو حرف امتناع لامتناع. That it is a حرف لامتناع. حرف of امتناع لامتناع. That there's a condition and there's a consequence. If the condition wasn't met, then there's obviously not going to be any consequence with regards to that matter. Example, if you pass, you will get 10 rands. Well, you didn't pass, so you will not get 10 rands. Jayed. Or for example, if you don't study, then you will fail. If you don't study, then you will fail. Well, you didn't study, and the consequence was that you failed. Jayed. So they say to us that وتفيد ثلاثة أمور, and it denotes 3 things: شرطية, condition, تقييد الشرطية بالزمن الماضي, that this condition is related to the past, الامتناع, that if the condition is not met, so obviously the consequence is obviously absent. Example: لو اجتهد لنجحت. لو اجتهد لنجحت. If you studied, then you would have passed. معناه لم تجتهد. You didn't study. فلم تنجح. And so you didn't pass. يقترن جوابها المثبت باللام. That the affirmative type of sentence we add a lam to it. وَلَا يَقْتَرِنْ بِهَا جَوَابُهَا الْمَنْفِيُّ. But if the jawab, if the consequence is negative, then we don't add any lam to it. يَجُوزُ عَكْسُهُ وَهَذَا قَلِيلٌ. And the opposite is something permissible, but it is rare. Example, لو سمعت قصته لبكيت. If you heard his story, you would have cried. قال المدرس لحامد لو حضرت أمس ما شكوتك إلى المدير. If you were present yesterday, I would not have complained about you to the principal. هذا طعام فاسد. This food is gone off. لو أكله الناس. لو أكله الناس لمرضوا. If people ate it, they will get sick. لو رأيت ذاك المنظر لبكيت. لو رأيت ذاك المنظر لبكيت. If you saw that sight, you would have cried. لو رأيت ذاك المنظر لبكيت. If you saw that sight, you would have cried. لو عرفت أن الرحلة اليوم ما تأخرت. If I knew that the travel was today, I would not have delayed. Then number two, or rather number one, they want us to add low into the following sentences. So we need to complete the sentence. ضربني ذاك الولد ضربته. جيد. لو ضربني ذاك الولد لضربته. If that boy hit me, I would hit him. لو ضربني ذاك الولد لضربته. If that boy hit me, I would hit him. جميل. Number two. عرفت أن المدرس مسافر. And then ما جئت. لو عرفت أن المدرس مسافر ما جئت. لو عرفت أن المدرس مسافر ما جئت. لو عرفت, if I knew, أن المدرس مسافر, that the teacher was on travel, ما جئت, I would not have come. تأخرت دقيقتين فاتتني الطائرة. الله مستعان. لو تأخرت دقيقتين, if I was late by 2 minutes, لفاتني الطائرة, then I would have missed the plane. سمعت تلاوة هذا القاري بكيت. أراد بكيت. لو سمعت تلاوة هذا القاري لبكيت. لو سمعت تلاوة هذا القاري. If you heard the recitation of this قاري, you would have cried. لو سمعت تلاوة هذا القاري لبكيت. قرأت هذه القصة ضحكت كثيرا. لو قرأت هذه القصة, if you read this story, لضحكت كثيرا, you would have laughed a lot. عرفت أنه يكذب ما ساعدته. لو عرفت أنه يكذب, if I knew that he was lying, ما ساعدته, I would not have helped him. لو عرفت أنه يكذب ما ساعدته. And the last one, زادت درجاتي بنصف درجة نجحت بتقدير ممتاز. لو زادت درجاتي, if my marks were increased, بنصف درجة, by half a mark, لنجحت, then I would have passed, بتقدير ممتاز, I would have passed with excellent grades. لو زادت درجاتي بنصف درجة, if my marks were increased by half a mark, لنجحت بتقدير ممتاز, then I would have passed with excellent grades. الله مستعان. أكمل الناقص فيما يلي. Complete the following. لو something something ما رسبت. لو something something ما رسبت. جيد. لو اجتهد ما رسبت. لو درست ما رسبت. If you studied, then you would not have failed. جيد. لو عرفت أنك تأتي إلى المدينة لو عرفت أنك تأتي إلى المدينة لو عرفت أنك تأتي إلى المدينة ما سافرت I would not have traveled I would not have traveled and previous one was لو اجتهدت so it's either you're talking about yourself or somebody else لو اجتهدت if I exerted myself and studied ما رسبت I would not have failed number three لو something something لمرضت لو أكلت ذلك الطعام الفاسد لمرضت لو أكلت ذلك الطعام لو أكلت ذلك الطعام if you ate that food الفاسد that food which was gone off لمرضت you would have gotten sick number four لو something لفاتتنا ركعة لو تأخرنا لفاتتنا ركعة لو تأخرنا if we were late لفاتتنا ركعة if we were late we would have missed a ركعة لو تأخرنا لفاتتنا ركعة جميل جميل exercise number three أدخل لو في جملتين على أن يكون جوابهما في الأولى مثبتا وفي الثانية منفيا. Let's see. لو زرتني أمس لو زرتني أمس if you visited me yesterday لأكلت طعاما لذيذا you would have eaten lovely tasty food لو زرتني أمس لأكلت طعاما لذيذا if you visited me yesterday you would have eaten tasty food now the negative لو عرفت أنك مريض ما تأخرت If I knew that you were sick, I would not have delayed لو عرفت أنك مريض ما تأخرت In the negative, we do not bring any lam We don't add any lam والحمد لله من قبل يبنى قبل وبعد على الضم إذا قطع عن الإضافة لفظا لا معنى قال الله تعالى لله الأمر من قبل ومن بعد We covered this matter that if we have example من قبل ذلك من بعد ذلك and then we remove the ذلك the مضاف إليه we make it محذوف we remove it and then what happens is it becomes قبل not قبلي بل rather قبل and بعد جميل تمارين عامة general exercises they say to us the مضارع استقبل يستقبل استقبل يستقبل to welcome انتظر ينتظر to wait انتظر he waited ينتظر he is waiting سافر he traveled يسافر he is traveling ساعد he helped يساعد he is helping رحب he welcomed يرحب he is welcoming مكث he remained يمكث he is remaining لبث similar he remained يلبث he is remaining يكسب he is earning كسب يكسب فات فات he missed يفوت he is missing ضر he harmed يضر he is harming the مفرد زوار زائر زوار زائر شداد the singular is شديد شديد what's the plural of جريح جريح جرحا جرحا as for نفس نفوس أو أنفس نفوس أو أنفس what's the opposite of ضر 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 means to harm and the opposite would be نفع 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 to benefit add the following words into sentences خال empty هذا البيت خال this house is empty جريح نقل الجريح إلى المستشفى the injured was taken to hospital استقبل استقبل عندما وصلت إلى المطار استقبلني زميلي when I arrived at the airport my friend welcomed me استقبلني he welcomed me ضر يضرني الجلوس تحت المروحة It harms me sitting under the fan. جيد. ساعد ساعد ساعدني زميلي اليوم. My colleague helped me today. فاتني الطائرة. فاتني الطائرة. I missed the plane. رحب. زرت صديقي فرحب بي. I visited my friend and he welcomed me. زرت صديقي فرحب بي. زرت صديقي فرحب بي. I visited my friend and he welcomed me. والحمد لله. يا عبد الله يا أمة الله, this lesson was a bit long. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you khair and barakah and grant you determination bi'iznillahi ta'ala. We end off with a prophetic maxim insha'Allah. What a beautiful way to end off our majlis. The words of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. What a beautiful hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. المسلم, definition of a Muslim. The Muslim is the one who other Muslims are safe from his tongue and they are safe from his hands. Subhanallah. This is ukhuwa. This is brotherhood. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah. That their bodies are safe from being harmed by you, and also they are safe from your tongue. The matter of your hasad and your jealousy and your hatred, etc., etc., all of these illnesses of the heart, they do not translate themselves. They do not translate themselves into action upon your tongue and upon your hands. Allahu musta'an. Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the matter of the tongue first. Why? Maybe because people are so lax with regards to them. Maybe because many a times the destruction of them is even greater. Allahumma musta'an. Maybe because you have slander, you have shatim, you have la'an, cursing, you have ghiba, namima, you have backbiting, you have swearing, you have so many different, you have lies, so many different false testimony, etc. So many different types of evil can emanate upon our tongues. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah. The true Muslim is the one who other Muslims are safe from his tongue and are safe from his hands. Subhanallah. That is the definition of the Muslim. That's a prophetic definition of the Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the Sahaba, who's the one who's bankrupt? The one who doesn't have money. He says, no, rather the one who comes on Yawmul Qiyamah and he did Hajj and this program and that program and this lecture and this event and this and that and all of these things, Hajj and Umrah and all of that fasting. But he swore this one and he harmed that one and he maybe shed the blood of this one and he did all of these things. And so they will take away from all of his good deeds until he has nothing. And if he hasn't sorted out, then the evil deeds of the people who were affected are taken and put onto his scales. This is truly the person who is bankrupt. Allah musta'an. May Allah not make us from amongst those who are bankrupt. Imagine you do Hajj and Umrah and Salah and Zakah and Siyam and this program and that program and reading the Noble Quran and lessons, etc. But you talk bad about people and you belittle people and you make fun of them and you backbite people and you carry tales. Then all of your good deeds goes to them. Allahu musta'an, Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, look after your deeds because it's your capital and it's your currency in the hereafter. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in good. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us away from evil. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins past and present. Those committed in the brightness of the day and those committed in the darkness of the night. Those that people know about and our sins that people do not know about. We ask Allah to forgive us for all of that until we meet again. Barakallahu feekum. Hada wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala abdihi wa rasulihi nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.